I am Dr. Keshav Valase from Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. In today's session, we'll be talking about 3D geometric transformations. In earlier video sessions, we have discussed about 2D, and in this session, we'll be talking about 3D geometric transformations. Regarding learning outcomes, at the end of this session, the viewers are expected to understand about explaining different types of 3D geometric transformations, more particularly about translation, scaling, and rotation. This is we are talking on three-dimensional aspects. At the same time, viewers are expected to solve the problems in 3D geometric transformations. Let us revise few things as basics from 2D geometric transformations, which are covered in earlier videos. Geometric transformations are basically nothing but the operations which are used to modify the given object's shape, size, its position, and orientation with respect to its current position or current configuration. As we have discussed earlier, a point normally we represent in biaxial system with xy coordinates, which we perceive as a 1 by 2 matrix, and a line we perceive as a 2 by 2 matrix, a line passing through two coordinates x1 y1 and x2 y2, we perceive it as a 2 by 2 matrix. So this is a basic fundamental aspect of how we represent points and lines and similarly other features in geometric transformations. Coming to the basics of conceptual aspect on transformations, these geometric transformations are basically carried out on the points which represent the given object. So while we are transforming any object, conceptually we are transforming points which represent the object. What I mean is, if you are talking about a line, then in transforming a line, we are basically transforming these two points which represent the line, and then that line as a graphics feature is redrawn at a new position of the points with its basic algorithm of a representation of line. Thus, again to repeat here, geometric transformations are basically carried out on the points which are used to represent the objects, and again at that new position, objects are redrawn. In this session, we will be elaborating on 3D translation, 3D scaling, and 3D rotation. These are three commonly used geometric transformations. There are many more transformations required, but these three are primarily and very widely used. So we'll be focusing on these three types of transformations in 3D. At this point, I expect the viewers to think about any objects in three dimensions and imagine the changes due to transformations. You can imagine any object in 3D and how these transformations would affect that particular given object. Just think for a while. Coming to first transformation of 3D translation, here as indicated here in the figure, P is initial position, original position of the given point with the x, y, z coordinates in three-dimensional representation. P dash is the new translated position of the point. We are talking first on the point here. And this T as a matrix would give you the translational distances. What do we do in this is, in 3D translation, we are moving an object, say here a point, from one position to another position, wherein we are not altering the dimensions of the object. We know the relationship P dash is the new translated position of a point, the point translated, that is equal to P, the coordinates of the matrix representing the original point, the position of original point, and T is the translation matrix. Now here P would be XYZ original dimensions, T the translation matrix is TX, TY, TZ, wherein these three TX, TY and TZ, they represent the distances of translation along X, Y and Z axis. Thus, with this basic relationship for translation, we have this relation wherein this is P dash, which is X dash, Y dash and Z dash representing this particular point, is equal to X, Y, Z, the original coordinates of the point, 3D we are talking, so X, Y and Z, three points, three coordinates of position, this point P in its original status. And we are adding to that these three parameters, which are increments the distances of translation along X, Y and Z axis. So, this is how in all in translation in 3D case, we have three points coordinates for translated new position as well as old position and the distances. Coming to 3D scaling, here either we reduce the object or enlarge the object in scaling, and the scaling factor along all the axes X, Y, Z, it may or may not be same. So, Sx, Sy and Sz, if these three we take as the scaling factors along X, Y and Z axis respectively, then we use these three scaling factors to reduce or enlarge the given object as it is given in this figure. Mathematically, in matrix form, we can put the relation as given here. P dash is equal to P into S. In case of scaling, we multiply two matrices. So, this P, the given point, its matrix, we multiply with this scaling matrix. Scaling matrix happens to be with Sx, Sy and Sz as scaling factors put up along the diagonal of 3 by 3 matrix, rest all values 0. We are talking on 3D scaling. So, multiplication of this matrix with the point, original point, will give us new position of the point after scaling. Coming to rotation, as indicated in the figure, the given object can be rotated through certain angle, say theta, about origin. Necessarily, the rotation of the points representing the object happens about the origin. Plus theta, if the angle is given, then the rotation is counterclockwise. If that angle of rotation is minus theta, the rotation happens in clockwise direction. Coming to the mathematical representation, as we know, again in P dash, the new coordinate is equal to P old coordinate into R. R is a rotational matrix. Now, here this Rz, Ry and Rx, these three are the matrices to be used for a rotation about z, y and x axis respectively. So here we see this particular matrix, if we multiply here, we get the rotation about z axis. If we use this particular matrix Ry, it gives a rotation about y axis. And if you are using this third matrix Rx, that gives us the rotation about x axis. Thus, whichever the rotations we need, we can have the combination of those 1, 2 or 3 requirements of these and ultimately get the rotation in 3 dimensions for the given object. Now, these are the references wherein these first 3 are from some sites wherein we have used the schematic representations, and this 4th and 5th, they represent 2 books of Gadkam by M.P. Grover and Ibrahim Zaid. Thank you.